Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to use Jupyter Notebook on Visual Studio Code. So I'm going to write a Hello World program on Jupyter Notebook, and that too within Visual Studio Code, and I'm going to also show you how to get that output so you can start your machine learning journey right on Visual Studio Code itself by setting up Jupyter Notebook. So everything I'm going to show you on this video itself. So do watch the video till the end. If you're facing any issues, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there and you can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to use Jupyter Notebook on Visual Studio Code, you will need basically two things first. One is Python and secondly Visual Studio Code itself. Just simply go to favorite browser and just simply type over here Visual Studio Code download. So let's first download both these two software, Visual Studio Code and Python. So just simply click on this download button and now you have Visual Studio Code rightly downloaded. So you can see that our Visual Studio Code is rightly started downloading. Next software that we'll need is Python. So just type Python download and go to their official site of Python and download latest version of Python at the time you're making of this video. So that will also going to download our Python, and you can see both these softwares are rightly downloaded. So let's minimize our browser and go to download directory, and you can see both our Visual Studio Code and Python is rightly downloaded. So we need to install it. So let's start with Python. So just simply double click on the installer. It will show you this Python installation wizard. Here you need to select both these two options and click on custom installation. Here under optional features, you need to keep everything as default and click on next. Here under advanced options, you need to select the first one, that is install Python 3.13 for all users, and click on install. So that's going to immediately ask for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and you can see that our Python installation is directly began. So by the time our Python get installed, next software that we need to install is Visual Studio Code. So just simply double click on the installer, and that will show you this license agreement. You need to read this, accept it, and click on next. So again, click on next. So that will show you this Visual Studio Code folder. Totally fine. Click on next. You need to check all these different options and click on next again. Again, click on install. So preparing to install, and our installation is also rightly begun. So let's minimize this, and you can see that both our Visual Studio Code and Python is rightly started installing. So it's going to take a couple of minutes. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you to subscribe your channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos. So do subscribe your channel Geeky Syntax, and along with, if you want, you can also watch all these different videos on WordPress. So you can watch this entire playlist. So some videos are 1 hour videos, some videos are 1 hour 13 minute video. So if you're interested, you can always watch all these different videos on our playlist. Alright, so here let's wait for a couple of minutes. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that both our Visual Studio Code and Python are directly installed. So you can just simply click on close for Python, and you can simply click on finish for Visual Studio Code. So that's going to launch our Visual Studio Code. We also have a shortcut over here. So next time onwards, you can just simply double click on it to launch your Visual Studio Code as well. So this is the interface of Visual Studio Code. Let's first maximize it, and let's close this welcome note and quickly jump over to extensions, and here just simply search Jupyter. So that's going to show you this Jupyter extensions over here, and it is developed by Microsoft, so it is totally fine. So it's going to install all these different four extensions along with this one. So we are basically going to install this extension pack 4. So click on install, and that's going to install all these different extensions along with the main Jupyter. So you need to hack the internet connections, and I can see that that is also done. So get started with Jupyter Notebook. Welcome note is also shown. So you can always click on this, you know, buttons over here to create a new Jupyter Notebook. All right. So for the time being, I'll click on close. Next thing that we need to install is Python. So just remove Jupyter and type Python, and that will show you Python over here. So install this Python extensions as well, and it is also developed by Microsoft, and you can see that that is also rightly done. So let's close this. So let's close our welcome note as well and go to Explorer. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to press on our keyboard Ctrl Shift P. So that will open Visual Studio palette over here. So here just simply type create Jupyter, and immediately we'll see this option of coming over here. So create a new Jupyter notebook. So just simply click on that, and that's going to immediately create a untitled IP1NB file. So here you can already see that we got an embedded Jupyter notebook version on our Visual Studio code immediately. Right, so you can write all of your coding stuff over here. So let's first save our file. So go to file and click on save as, and let's go to our desktop and save this file. So let's give a file name something like hello world. Alright, just click on enter, and you can see it is actually saved. So you can always minimize this when you click on that. Okay, so yeah, so here you can write your Python program. So let's print something on our console. So let's print something like hello world, and so write something like this, and you already see that our Python 3.13.1, the version that we have installed, is already rightly recognized. So our kernel is rightly set. So now if you just simply click on this run button for this particular shell, immediately you can see it is telling that it is connecting to Python kernel, and it is showing this pop-up. So here we need to install Python 3.13 IPY kernel packages. So just simply hit install, and it's going to install IPY kernel as well. So you can see it is rightly doing that. So you know, let's wait for some time, and you can see that it is rightly installed, and currently it is connecting to that kernel, and it is rightly connected, and it is also showing the output over here, right? Hello world. So let's say you want to add one more code cell, and let's say you want to print summation of two numbers. So let's say 5 plus, or let's say 7 plus 8, and just simply click on this run button. You can see the output coming, right? You can also create a markdown. You can write something like hello, and then click on this tick icon, and you can see that is coming. You can create one more code cell, and you can do all of your programming stuff on Jupyter Notebook, and that too within Visual Studio Code. Alright, so in this way you set up Jupyter Notebook on Visual Studio Code. I'll also request you to follow our Anaconda video, so that will show you how to use Spider ID as well. Alright, so that is basically all about this video, friends. Don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax, and also watch our other WordPress videos as well on our channel. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.